Hello and happy Resurrection Sunday to all of my Pisces. This is Queen Amun-Ra coming to you with your Sunday reading. Hopefully you all are having a great weekend. I know that you are because you're texting me and letting me know that you are. And I appreciate that. Let's get right into your reading. This is a general reading for my Pisces Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or wherever Pisces is in your chart. If you happen to come across this video because you're cross-watching for someone else, please check your birth chart. There's plenty of free resources online where you can check your birth chart to see if Pisces is in your chart. And stick around and listen to see if anything resonates with you in the video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. All right, so it looks like somebody is learning how to take their power back, their power and their intellect, which is great. And it's going to also align with your money. And things are going to happen rather quickly for you, Pisces. You all are empaths, so you already know exactly what to do. We're still very much full moon in Libra. You're learning how to balance out your own scales of justice. But again, some of you all may feel like you're by yourselves. And use this time wisely while you're by yourselves to really think back over your lives. Not necessarily focus on who hurt you and how bad they hurt you and that kind of thing, but more or less like, okay, I have an opportunity right now to rewrite my own story. I don't have to stay in this place of being stuck. I don't have to stay in this place of feeling just like, whoa, you know, is me. Right? So instead, I see somebody really looking back over their lives. We're talking about the King of Swords. Looking back over your life with much clarity, again, compassion first and foremost for yourselves, having compassion for other people, but saying, you know what? I choose me instead, right? I really choose me instead. So moving forward, I see somebody carving out some space for speaking things into existence like a new, increase in money in your life. How being very creative, because you're a very creative sign. You're very wise. You're very gentle. You're very compassionate. You all are self-healers. Natural healers. And you're selfless. But this is where you're going to naturally heal yourselves in this time of being by yourselves. Just you and your ancestors, you know, and freeing yourselves from any kind of bondage that you may feel. Again, this is a general reading. Take only what resonates with you, right? You can apply it to any part of your life. If you're interested in a personal reading, my information is down below. This is a critical time for you all, Pisces. Instead of looking at your life and saying, all these people hurt me, I can't believe it. Instead of being victim, say, I'm a survivor of a lot of things that have hurt me in the past. A lot of betrayal, backstabbing, all of those things. And now that I've gotten up, resurrection, right now that I've resurrected myself, and I recognize this is what I have to do. I have to tap more into my divine masculine sign, because if I don't, then I'm risking this. I don't want people to feel like, you know, I'm not smart enough, or I just don't see things, or like, what is wrong with me, until you start buying into that. But this is also trying to get to you business ideas, right? So in this time, it's a great time for you all to balance out your own scales. Again, headed towards the last quarter moon in Aquarius, which is going to really put that wind up under your, put that wind up under you to just kind of empower you to start getting serious about your future. Again, here we have you balancing out your daily affairs when it comes to money. And I see you have the Midas touch, which is amazing. Things are going to happen really fast for you, Pisces. So don't be surprised when you speak things into existence. All of a sudden, they're just boom, they're starting to happen. Don't get scared. Don't get nervous. Remember, you spoke it into existence. See, this is when you're going to start to realize, Pisces, that all that good energy you've been putting out to the universe, boom, here it is. It's been waiting for you to collect. Just all that interest you've been putting out in the universe, now it's time for you to collect. And it's going to happen fast. The money is going to happen fast. The ideas are going to come very quickly. All because you took a leap of faith and said, okay, instead of me lying there being the victim, let me get up from this space and say, okay, all that rejection, hurt, backstabbing, people running smear campaigns, all of that, it was meant for me to be by myself, so now I can be a lighthouse to other people. Yeah, because if we're around all of that other stuff, it was just too distracting. Way too distracting. I see somebody at their highest frequency now. See, let me show you something about something that may have happened to you in the past. Let me show you. Some of you all have been in this space in the past, right? thinking that people were sending black magic your way and sending spells and all of that, blocking your money. But really what it was is that you weren't taking that move to sever ties with certain energies in your life because they were a distraction to you. So you're literally sitting in front of a vault filled with everything that you want behind that vault. You just have to stay at your highest frequency. This is such a critical time for you all to really stay laser focused, Pisces, not to start wavering, because it's a full moon energy, and full moon energy is really fully illuminating your own internal path. So your spiritual path, so you can see who hurt you, but you can also see why you would never let them back in your space too. So it's good to look back and say, okay, I've really come through this, right? That's going to help you feel rejuvenated and happy and give you that extra fire up under you to start coming up with those ideas for your business and all those things. Again, the whole purpose of lessons is, what did you learn about yourself? Not about who did what to you and how horrible they were and all of that. That's holding space for something that's blocking the things that you've been asking for. So yes, what did you learn on this long and arduous journey of self-discovery, right? Four of Wands. Again, I see somebody celebrating outside of your new business, celebrating outside your house, or even a core house, because maybe you met your king or queen of pentacles. Right? If that's what you want. You met your king or queen. So this person is matching your energy financially. If that's what you want, right? Yeah. But again, you got to speak it into existence. That's the only way you're going to get it, is if you speak it into existence. This is not the time. I'm telling you, I can't reiterate this, and this is why I keep repeating it. I see somebody, you know, celebrating outside of their business that they've created, because they've gotten out of their own head and wondering, you know, just almost wanting to escape. I can't believe this many people hurt me, and you want to put on some rose-colored glasses and just escape into another universe. This is where you're, dealing with it head on, Pisces, and saying, nope, I'm not escaping this time. Let me take off the rose-colored glasses. I see exactly what it is. Let me get busy on my, you know, putting some fire up under myself, right? Queen of Pentacles, right? So this is a person who is genuinely compassionate, but there's a lot of money in your cards that you could be leaving on the universe table if you're just sitting there thinking about, you know, and I'm not even saying playing victim, because it's not playing victim. Some of you all were really deeply wounded by people that you love and trusted and cared about. And some of those people you may never receive an apology from. But guess what? You're not sitting around waiting for them to give you an apology either. Just want to make sure everybody's straight. You don't have to wait around for somebody to give you an apology. You close it out yourselves. You close it out. Five of Wands. Somebody was dealing with somebody with a lot of internal conflict, even if it's in your own family. Stop. People assume that, oh, we can't have all of that going on in our family. Why not? Why not? You could have people in your own family that just have a lot of conflict. They could be dealing with some mental health issues that you're not even aware of. But for you, as compassionate as you are, you've seen enough. You've seen enough. It comes off as jealousy and envy. It comes off as, you know, burning you with a blowtorch or whatever. But again, this is where you free yourself and be grateful that you got burned with that torch. So you can say, okay, it's time for me to move on. Show the world the real you. Some of you all may have Aquarius in your chart, but when I talk about signs, just so we're crystal clear, every sign is ruled by a planet. So I'm not talking about people. I'm talking about when I toss out signs, you say, oh my God, yes, I was hurt by an Aquarius. Abandon that, really, because it'll keep you stuck and it'll block you from prospering in other areas of your life. Because what if God put your next promotion in the hands of an Aquarius? That's if you had an issue with an Aquarius. Instead, Aquarius is ruled by two planets, Saturn and Uranus. Uranus is the planet of spontaneity, this planet of change, the planet of uniqueness, right? So the way that they go about doing things is very different from any other sign. And also it's the Saturn, which is the other ruling planet, is the planet of long-term goals, dreams, ambitious responsibilities, So they're a very hardworking sign, but it's money is not the primary goal for them, and that's why they attract so much of it, but they also push it away too. So the way that they go about things are very differently. So you could have Aquarius in your chart, so speak to the Aquarius in you versus saying, "Oh my God, I was hurt by an Aquarius," or any sign for that matter. Find out what their ruling planet is, and remember, we are having human experiences as humans, as human beings. We also have free will. So just because one Aquarius, and I'm just using Aquarius or Sagittarius, is a Sagittarius. Let's say an Aquarius or Sagittarius hurt you. Just because one or two Sagittarius or Aquarius hurt you doesn't mean that they're all that way. You got to see yourself and people. Okay, if I have Aquarius or Sagittarius in my chart, let me go watch the videos and see, what they look like at their highest frequency, so I can know to separate that one from that one, right? Yes, somebody is connecting with their womb. I'm talking to men and women, Pisces. You all are, really connecting with whatever you're passionate about. If somebody's passionate about creating music or singing or poetry or some kind of arts or something, boom, get right back into it. Because again, you're balancing out your own scale. So you're releasing some things. This is the whole purpose of you being by yourself right now. For you to really seriously think about, what do I want my next steps to look like? What do I want my future to look like? I certainly don't want my future to look like me sitting around, giving these people who hurt me the power. I don't need to do that. No, I don't need to do that. Here we have, I will imagine five things I could do that no one would ever expect, and then I will do at least one of them. That's right. That's what you can busy your time with doing, right? Something that's going to really shock and surprise you, right? You were made for creativity. If that's not the truth, I don't know what is, Pisces. Yes, you were made for creativity. But this is your reading. This is how you are re resurrecting yourselves. On some cards, the person is lying down with 10 swords stabbed in and presumably left for dead. But you, Pisces, got up from that space of being stabbed in the back, talked about, laughed at, ridiculed, whatever. You got up from that space where people just didn't think that you were ever going to make it to where you are. But guess what? Here you are, wealthy, right? So again, stay focused. Don't worry about people and their mental health issues. That's why we have tons of mental health professionals out here. And so it's not your job to save them. Even if you are a social worker, a psychiatrist, psychologist, or therapist, you can refer them to other people because, again, it's too close for comfort. They will still be disrespectful towards you. They will still be hurtful towards you. So you got to either refer them to somebody else or get the heck out of the way so that they'll find someone else, so that they'll find some help. Okay? That's what I have for you. I'll see you in a couple of days. Bye.